Recording?
Yes, yes, I pushed the button this time.
Push the button, Frank.
Okay, hi, I'm ewhac.
I'm gammadev.
And I hope you all had a lovely holiday. How about you?
I had an okay holiday.
Okay, I had an okay holiday as well.
It was a fine end to the crappy year that was 2013, so...
Yeah.
For various reasons.
Yes. And we're going to try a shot at Way of the Warrior here, which is going to be somewhat tricky because of the heavily copyrighted music underneath of it and YouTube getting all pissy about incidental cuts and hits triggering takedowns from all their bots. I got to wonder if a bot sends a takedown notice, is that legal? Because in order to send a takedown notice, you have to affirm that you are legally entitled. You are either the copyright holder or you are an authorized agent of the copyright holder to issue a takedown notice. As far as I'm aware, a bot cannot be designated as an agent. So if you're observing a DMCA takedown notice that comes from a bot without any human review whatsoever.
I don't know. The law probably doesn't say it has to be a person that affirms that it belongs to them. Well, first of all, it's a person affirming that it belongs to them. The bot is just carrying out the request of, like, somebody said, I own this, and therefore it's mine. And they, as they point out, there are people who are making claims of ownership that don't actually own the thing. Mm-hmm. Either mistakenly they're doing it.
Yeah, mistakenly, uh-huh.
No, there was apparently one large channel that unfortunately claimed that this is not new for YouTube, like I said, was said before you started recording. That this has been going on for like well over 6 months, these bots giving takedown notices to individuals who do this like yourself. Mm-hmm. But now the reason you're hearing about so much is because there were these large multi-partner groups, mm-hmm, that used to be exempt from this stuff. And the reason was YouTube said if they were like a YouTube partner with advertising and all that stuff,
yeah,
and they had a thing, had a large network, mm-hmm, YouTube would say, you guys can police yourselves.
Right.
Just affirm that none of your partners are doing this. Well, basically that grace period is now over. So now the companies that are basically, this is their living, is making YouTube videos, mm, are now being affected by this. And so that's why you're hearing, quite frankly, whining about it. whereas like a lot of the smaller guys who've been, mm, you know, just individuals who do this, they're like, now you're complaining about this? I've been dealing with this for like a better part of the year. So, and apparently one of these large channels made the mistake on like their first day of this whole thing, mm-hmm, affirming that every video in their channel, they owned it. So anybody who used content, for instance, if they did like, say, a playthrough of Borderlands 2, anybody else who did a playthrough of Borderlands 2 would get triggered by the bot saying, hey, this guy claims that they own this, uh-huh, Borderlands 2 sound, yeah, footage, yeah, whatever. So therefore, if you had it, they got a takedown notice from this. And the claim was by this one group. Mm-hmm. And this person who did this apparently is like, mea culpa, sorry, I didn't mean to do that. I just didn't understand, basically didn't understand how YouTube worked, you know? Because anybody can just affirm, I own this, to YouTube.
Right.
And their automated system, because as somebody pointed out, it's like every minute there's 100 hours of new video uploaded,
yeah,
to YouTube. Mm-hmm. So when somebody says, like, you know, if the government ever tries to subpoena YouTube, it's like, yeah, right, you're going to pull up a truck full of hard drives. We'll start filling it up now and we'll finish, oh, never. to send that right over to the Justice Department. Mm-hmm. So it's like, yeah.
Enjoy yourselves.
We'll fax that right over to you.
Yeah, we'll just get that. Yeah, every frame in a
101. No, just like 1000. That's how Google should handle that when the government says, we want all your data. It's like, okay, we'll fax that over to you. 1001. Make sure you put the paper into the fax machine. Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. RCR,
you didn't say that. How we had to deliver it to you. This is how we archive stuff at YouTube.
I was looking at some of the Bridgegate stuff out of New Jersey, and they were subpoenaing all the emails, and it's clear that all the emails records are faxed. They're faxed images. It's not machine readable. I'm going, what the hell?
Well, I assume fax are machine readable.
Well,
you could scan them back.
Why aren't they sending like the original text stuff. But anyway.
To slow down the process, obviously. Anyway, we should probably talk about
the Well, that's another thing. something that happened during the break is that the great Yahtzee Croshaw started a new set of videos called Let's Drown Out. Which is, apparently he's seen a number of Let's Play videos where they start playing a game and then start talking about anything but the game. And so...
He stole that from us. We've been doing that for years.
Well, actually. But yeah, so apparently this form of video is now called Let's Drown Out. Anyway,
we have a legitimate reason, which is the fact that this thing probably uses the most appropriate music ever in a fighting game, which is White Zombie.
Yeah.
It's like, you know.
Yeah.
Which is, that's what you get when your little indie developers suddenly get snapped up by Universal Interactive. And, mm-hmm. So,
what kind of music would you like to have?
Yeah, it's like, White Zombie. It's, and it's like, okay. It's like, what? It's like this is Naughty Dog Software's first game. Developer that is quite prominent, went on to great things. Crash Bandicoot basically saved the PlayStation by giving an actual mascot character. Mm-hmm. Because before that, they had, like, some scantily clad chick from Bel Air and Toshinden. They tried using that as their mascot character. It was like Sofia or something like that. Or,
obviously very memorable. I can't remember what you're talking about.
Well, other fact is, like, it's appropriate for a family game console when you have, woman in a thong with a whip as your mascot. And then at one point they tried something called Polygon Man, which was just this horribly looking, it's sort of like some, like, second-rate version of the MCP, essentially. Like this polygonal talking head trying to be convincive, like, the future is polygons or whatever, and yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. And so they searched forever for a mascot character before Naughty Dog came in with Crash Bandicoot, which, apparently Crash Bandicoot started life as a 3DO title. Mm. It was their second title.
Uh-huh.
So for all those of you who didn't buy Way of the Warrior when it came out, you're the reason Crash Bandicoot went to the PlayStation. Because this game didn't sell well. For reasons we will get into.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah, basically this is the first garage developer, fighting game for the 3DO by, a couple of kids at MIT.
MIT, really?
I'm pretty sure that's them.
Okay.
I'm
sure the net will correct us.
Yes. But yeah, because certainly Sony wouldn't have given these kids a dev kit.
Oh, Lord no.
Yeah, so basically... I believe they're either recent MIT grads or actual students at the time.
Hmm.
And a lot of the people in this game are basically their friends and classmates. Yeah. They'll say, hey, I can throw a punch. Okay. Because apparently I'd heard stories that, all these things were digitized. Graphics were done in their dorm room.
Mm-hmm.
Done by them opening the door and shooting from the hall because they didn't have enough space.
They didn't have enough distance on the lens.
So standing out in the hall shooting into their room with a makeshift blue screen in the background while people did their moves. Maybe
it's
why
not,
they don't
not
move
too different from the way it's done today. It's just people like putting up a green screen on their wall. And
yes, and so then
top five with
Mark Cerny, another name that's now prominent, especially always been prominent, but now really prominent on the PlayStation 4, is the father of the PS4.
Taking a little flack
for the PS4.
Yeah,
not for the PS4. He's taking flack for that somewhat underperforming game of his.
Knack.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I looked at that game and I said, if somebody told me this were on the Wii, I'd believe them. I mean, this is really, he's made up of particle effects, but somebody said it's like, and the hopes of him being a mascot character instantly evaporate the second he opens his mouth and starts talking.
Oh, really?
Yeah, apparently it has a very, shall we say, inappropriate voice for that character. It's like, so,
no, I haven't played it.
Don't have a PS4, haven't played it myself. Uh-huh. I've seen video and I'm just like, yeah, it looks like your generic 3D platformer kind of thing.
Do you have either of the new gen consoles?
I did. I got myself an Xbox One as a present to myself for getting a new job.
So, yay! Okay, sure.
Yeah, why not?
Why not? Look out, cat. Cat's walking across my lap.
I got a new job, and the second I looked online, there was just like a shipment had just become available for buying. Xbox Ones, because they were sold out for like several weeks, and I just got happened to get online at just the exact moment, so I thought, this is kismet, So anyway.
Alrighty, so we're gonna play. I can't remember how to play this game, so...
We're going to do versus mode here, so...
So, alright. So more and more, what does that mean?
Demo mode. To...
Oh, I just flipped over to demo mode.
How did you flip over to demo
mode? I pushed...
Yes.
They're friends, okay.
Yes, right. Well, you know, you work with what you have.
Of course.
And your first...
It's hey, I've got a hat.
It's their first game, guys. Yeah. So...
Yeah, whoops.
Well, I just...
Oh, you killed
I hit
out
the
of
start
it?
Button,
right.
So the...
All right, okay.
You could do a...
All right, so...
Is it
tournament mode, versus mode? Okay, okay. One of us is going to have to agree. Okay, so we're selecting versus mode?
Yes.
Okay, go.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, I am the red
I'm
one.
I'm blue. Okay. Major gains.
Oh, yeah, he had all the
Was this before or after Major Pain? Damon Wayans, like that crappy
classic
movie?
Talking pictures. Yeah. I have no idea.
Oh, he's from the UK.
Let's pick the guy, Shaky Jake.
Obviously Australian.
Australian.
Yeah, or at least the best as an MIT student can do in Australia. Oi. So...
Where are the... All right, so I have no idea. Round one, fight. So sorry, we've turned off all the music, because...
Imagine White knows. Zombie playing Thunder Kiss 1965 or whatever. That's the first track of this. Oh. So the tweeting birds really don't work for me. They're sound effect. I'm trying to remember the buttons like crazy here.
Yeah, I don't remember a darn thing. I'm just button mashing here.
So C looks like to be kick.
Jeez.
B is block, I guess. Yeah. And there's taunt. B is block and taunt. Okay.
Is that a coin?
Yeah, that's the thing. It's like they kind of drop power-ups, sort of power-ups, from the ceiling.
Okay.
Oh, you beat me. Shaky Jake is fond of the Fosters.
Oh, dear. Thanks for calling attention to that. Wahoo!
That staff of yours seems to give you an advantage.
Again, I am just mashing buttons.
And you're doing really good at that, too.
Wahoo! Is there like a power something? Oh. Jeez. Wahoo!
Oh, killed me, man.
What's the... Was that a, like a Christmas bell back there? So it's a best of three, I guess.
You fought like a wombat. Well, yeah, that's pretty typical to fight a game. Digitized characters aside, the backgrounds are very nice. You got nice effects with the snow and everything. Looks very... And I think this was the problem with the game in the sense that, okay, so the characters look like Mortal Kombat.
Mm-hmm.
But the backgrounds and even the fighting style are much closer to Street Fighter. And that's a really powerful move that you have there.
I have no idea what I'm doing. No idea what I'm doing.
You're winning. That's what you're doing. But, I mean, and they talked about this game quite a bit on the internet before...
Usenet, yeah.
Usenet, sorry. Yeah.
Before the game came out. Usenet is a subset.
And, you know, they were very big into making sure that this... Their favorite game was Street Fighter. They loved Street Fighter, but they liked the graphics of Mortal Kombat. So that this was their goal, the game was to make a game that, you know, had the graphics of Mortal Kombat and the mechanics of Street Fighter.
Huh.
Street Fighter is a fairly simplistic... hate mail for this. Fighting engine, Mortal Kombat is a very simplistic fighting engine. It's a very simple state machine. Like, for instance, when you just walking forward, there's like only like a few discrete parts on the screen you can actually stand. If you walk forward, you take a full step. You can't like
scooch forward like
right,
just to get inside your own range.
So basically it's like all about like when you started your fighting move, whether you're going to hit or not. It's known from like the very start of the fighting move whether you're actually going to hit somebody or not. Whereas Street Fighter is all about like hitboxes and stuff as you're fighting. Like if there's an opening, you'll get it. You know, it's very organic in that sense. And that's what they kind of did with this game.
I see.
And so a lot of people, when they saw this, they thought, oh, it's going to be like Mortal Kombat. And they played it, and they were really, they found it to be like, what they said, button masher. Really, it's more just, I think they felt, you know, it's a little more spazzy, which, you know, it's the classic, you know, Mortal Kombat guy, people who like Mortal Kombat versus people who like Street Fighter. Mm-hmm. Street Fighter is about, you know, really precise timing and hitting, whereas like Mortal Kombat is much a little slower paced, you know. It's all about the flash a bit. So instead of making a game that, you know, appeals to a larger audience. Oh, was I throwing grenades there for a second?
Yeah, it did look like that, yeah.
You know, they would play this. I don't know. That's a really powerful move you have there.
Kicking my nads out. Ow, quit it. Ow, quit it. Ow, quit it. Put him away. Time over.
Major game wins. Yay, finally.
Well, did I just fall over dead? Or
well, I was trying to do a finishing move on you. That didn't work. So,
so yeah, some of the finishing moves in this are kind of cool. Excuse me.
And like a lot of people complain when they would try and pull like Mortal Kombat moves like this, where they would like, for instance, you know, they would sit there and they'd block forever.
Yeah.
And what happens is the computer AI opponent would just immediately throw them. They're like, well, that's not fair. And it's like, well, that's what, that's pretty much what would happen in Street Fighter. If you sat there and blocked forever, it would throw you. And so they just weren't used to that. Yeah, so you're going to kill me. That staff of yours is really fun. And then and the other thing was also the balance in the game, which we might be seeing here. Because I'm picking a notoriously crappy fighter here. in
How's
major...
that feel? What?
There is a little bit of glitch.
Dropped on me there? What? What is this, bubble bobble? What?
Punching you in the nuts.
Now, quit it.
And, you know, so, you know, they're...
Yeah. Wasn't there a lot of complaints that people felt that there weren't enough frames in the animation?
Yeah, I mean, that was the other thing, because they had such large sprites, and they're all... And unlike Street Fighter, they're not, like, four-color or 16-color. They're, you know, full-color, so... They had to do a lot of little tricks to want to pick different fighters and different backgrounds,
yeah,
maybe.
I think so.
Some of the more interesting backgrounds. They felt, you know, they did a lot of tricks to like, and they did some really clever tricks to like conserve memory, like, you know, you know, flipping stuff, mirroring stuff, scaling, a lot of scaling. That's why like certain moves, you know, when guys catch fire, they make sure to pick somebody that's, let's see, who am I? Oh God, biker chick is really.
Yeah, they were using like coded six.
Oh God, I remember something about that. I actually went as this ninja for a Halloween at 3DO 1 year.
How did that work out?
Well, people immediately got who I was.
And okay.
It's kind of. Round one, fight. Do we have a chance to pick backgrounds?
I don't know. Oh, that's right.
This is kind of like the Chun-Li, you know, chick or whatever. So, yeah, she's able to throw. How are you throwing?
I have no idea. No idea.
Oh, like that. Okay. If I remember correctly, I can actually kick that lantern thing. And, you know, they're trying things with, like, different heights in the play field and stuff, which is, you know, that's pretty sophisticated. You know, they're attempting a whole bunch of different stuff here. You know, they're doing, you know, a mixture of, like, you know, digitized and, you know, drawn backdrops and stuff.
Ooh. Fatality? Really?
Yeah. I guess that's a fatality. Okay.
All right.
Like I said, things with like the drop power-ups and, you know. I think one of these, I think if there's like, if like, oh, that's right. He's got a, yeah, that's
oh,
his
great.
Thing. Oh, yes. I remember what I did for Halloween for this is to replicate that move.
Uh-huh.
I bought like cans of silly string and I would just whip them out of this. Like, I'm trying to remember here. It's like, there we go. And basically, that's a straight up Street Fighter move. Mm-hmm. It's a, you know, it's a quarter circle plus a button kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. Well, all right.
But I mean, it's also, I mean, also Mortal Kombat like kind of cheaped down its characters too. A lot of were palette swaps. A lot of them just like this guy has a blue mask. This guy now has a red.
Yeah,
and
has
a green mask. So it's like, let's even pick. Can we pick our backdrops? Or are we just getting random here?
I don't know. Oh, well, maybe.
Oh, I guess Arena.
Arena
guess.
Is where you.
Like, there's a few interesting ones here. Where Temple, they, this the one's pit. A good one. Yeah, the pit.
Yeah, jeez.
Oh, this guy.
We can pick the same guy.
Oh, okay. Well, that'll be confusing as all hell for both the viewers and for.
Do they give us a slightly different.
Can't remember if they did even bothered with palette swaps on it. That'd be the easiest thing to do on the 3D. Would be the palette swap, but nope.
Oh wait, so you're someone slightly more red. Okay, so
and this one is kind of interesting for. Oh, this is actually the worst guy to pick for this arena, because you can't do the finishing move on this arena then with this guy, because he doesn't, unless they have compensated for the fact that this character can't perform the. Yeah, so like you got a power up which makes you, I guess, intangible or something.
No, it's you that had the power up.
Wait, is that me?
You're slightly red.
Oh, I'm red. Okay.
Okay.
But yeah, I mean, this was like showing off like all the things you could do in the 3D. You know, the scaling backgrounds, the pseudo, you know, 3D effects, little, you know, lighting and stuff.
Yeah, no, they did. They did a remarkable job, especially for, you know, a bunch of guys.
And yeah, I mean, the AI in this is somewhat schizophrenic in the sense that it's really easy for the first couple of fights and then all of a sudden it just gets brutally hard.
Front the skeleton, seat, the skeleton there, yeah.
Fatality.
Forgotten about that.
Ring up.
Yeah.
Excuse me. But yeah, I mean, they, you know, there was such hype for this game, you know, because 3DO put this on a lot of, I think, game shows, because they were like, you know, look, this is an original game, it's for the 3DO, it's, you know, we're gonna have the next Mortal Kombat, and then, you know, it didn't, you know. Oops, sorry. Let's see here.
Oh, yeah, the roof has an interesting ring out. If
the roof is?
Yeah, it's, if you, I remember, like, if you can kick the person, like, way high up in the air, they fall through the roof to the floor below, and then this pool of blood shows up.
Right. Didn't the bridge also have...
I don't know. It's been a long time.
And let's see here. I'm going to try.
Yeah.
I'll try Samuel L. Jackson here. Hold on. Makes me wonder, was this guy their RA or something like this? The whole Fox here. Where are they now? It's like nice background here. His crane style, you know, it's like he's basically he takes the one move of the Karate Kid and takes it to entire fighting style.
The hell?
I don't know if that's his version of like his helicopter power kick or whatever. Oh, damn it. I was trying to do an uppercut. I don't know how to do an uppercut on this thing. To do the roof kill.
Yeah, I never got into fighting games myself.
So let's see. I assume it's... Is it... Let's see. How do you do an uppercut?
Oh.
Oops. I keep wanting to use B throw. How do you do uppercuts?
No idea. Part of the, like, hideous complexity of the button combos is one of the reasons I never got into this. Also because the games that I did see... my first exposure to fighting games was actually a combination of... Oh, what the heck was... I can't remember the name of the coin-op game, but it was like... I had like a frame rate of 2... and then there was Karateka on the Apple II, which was just, you know, like a slideshow practically.
Man, damn it, I don't know how to do an uppercut. I should look how to do an uppercut.
I'm sure it's on the net somewhere.
Or is it like one of those like it's like multi button combos or whatever? Is it like? That's kick.
That's punch. That's... So yeah. So A is like the arm. B is the arm, right. And then that's the fan. So what the? We both got invisibility. What the?
Yeah, at the same time.
Well, that hurt. That helps the rendering time. I don't know what I'm doing.
If I just figure out how to do an uppercut, that'd be fun. Is it like up down?
Ow. Oh, wake up, you idiot. Oh, stun lock, that's nice. What? Oh, what the
he's
hell?
He's got a shiv. I don't he shanked you.
I'm crying out loud.
Oh, if I could just figure out how to do an uppercut, man. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna do an uppercut if it kills me.
Oh, you're looking it up. Okay.
Uppercut. Way of the Warrior. Let's see how good Google is. Fox. Character blah, 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 blah. Normal moves. Backwards kick. Fatality. Oh, wait, this is one of those things. Oh, it's probably like a generic move. Backwards jump kick, uppercut kick, spin count. How about just a regular uppercut? DB and right shift. Down back and right shift, is that what that means?
Down back and right shift.
I'm so glad they put the character profile in here. Magics. Wow, there's magics. That's interesting.
I don't know that these controllers were ever really good enough for normal a super dude. Twitch game like this. And you know, not because of the buttons on the joypad itself. There was never any like firm sense that you'd like hit like a two direction combo.
Okay, upper.
I mean, I have enough trouble driving through Monster Manor.
How do I problem searching on a cell phone, man?
What, you don't have a phablet?
I don't, well. Ways special moves, lots of uppercuts. Well, that's good. I'm so happy. I guess he doesn't have it. Maybe he just doesn't have a traditional uppercut. Okay.
That's super
down,
special
back, uppercut. and right shift for his uppercut kick, I guess. So, down, back.
Okay. Jeez. Well, whatever it is, it's working.
Oh, I'm not doing it. I'm just taking advantage of...
Jeez.
Oh, damn it. I killed you too hard. Okay. Foxy. Come on. Okay, come on. I think I...
Guard, you moron.
Yeah, the whole dizzy mechanic, I think the people also objected to that you could do that mid-match, that you would get...
Do what?
Get that you would get, you know, dizzy mid-match, you know, as opposed to, like, just at the end, like you would in most of them.
Mm. Where are you? There.
Okay, hold on. Nope. I think I have to do that maybe closer to the center or something. You were too close to the edge maybe for it to do that.
I don't know. Mash.
Oh, who's in trouble? Okay, fuck you. See, I didn't want to... I'm trying not to, like, hit you with too powerful a shot there, so... Because it's like, well, then you'll just die. I can't have that. Ooh, that was a big-ass yin-yang coin you... and you picked it back up.
Ding!
What the hell?
Nibble away at your feet. There you go.
Oh, come on. Nope.
No.
You sure it's this one? Maybe it's the bridge?
It's pretty sure it's not the bridge. I remember peering down.
There is one on the bridge too. There's a let's try.
I remember peering down through a hole to the floor below and seeing, you know, the pool of blood spreading out from your defeated, it could be the dojo. I don't know. It's almost certainly not that.
Not that.
That's random select.
Oh, wait, the graveyard has one too, I think. Yeah, I'm going to stick with Fox. I like Fox.
No,
you're gonna try. You're gonna take Shaky Jake and his stick. That's not a stick.
Matched.
This is a stick.
I'm giving you an excellent view of my nostrils.
Is that a stick or a bong? It's almost college. It was like, please say it's not a rain stick.
No, rain sticks don't look like that. Ow.
I think this one is like.
Damn.
I will break you. Sounds like Ivan Drago there. Ah, oh, damn it. Killed you too much. Call the Conqueror. Hey, wait a minute. The Conan guys might have an issue with the...
I thought it was... Oh, that was the second film.
See, it's right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, his...
Woof. Yeah, okay, alright.
Oh, please save me. Nope. One of these, like, you click some... Yeah, it's not this one, I realize. I think it's the bridge. Oh, wait, no, I didn't want to hit...
Oh, well.
Screw that. No, we're gonna... Okay, if you want to... Was... Now, is that Cull character, is that... There was rumors that he was a playable... Like, he was the playable boss or something like that. He was the boss in the...
I don't actually remember. It's been forever.
And there's like, yeah, every... Actually, I think pretty much every arena has some fatality on it, has some kind of fatality if you know how to do it.
Right.
I thought this one was you kick him into a grave or something like that. I still don't know how I'm doing the shiv.
And do they have to be like in a special position of, on the playfield in order to...
He's dead.
You want to have a look at the bridge then?
Let's try the bridge.
All right.
Unless maybe the this guy's uppercut isn't sufficient for the. It's the only uppercut that he has. Like I said, I thought there was a generic uppercut that everybody could do, but I can't see it on the move list. I hope they're not. Given how much it's seeking, it makes me think that. Maybe it's the temple is the one that you're thinking
could
of.
Could be.
Let's try the temple. Oh, I guess we gotta. You don't want to try Biker Chick? She's tough because she wears leather. Oh, wait, no. You can't do this one. Or is this the one that has the ceiling fan? Like, one of these has... Doesn't one of them have a ceiling fan? Is it this one that has a ceiling fan?
Here. I just watched other people play this game. Major Gaines does that move, too.
Well, oh, darn it. That's too powerful a move.
Ta-da!
The temple, or is it the... Like, the... Is there also a dojo as well?
Yes,
the temple?
There is.
Oh, okay, so I think maybe it's the dojo that has... Either has what you're thinking of, or it has it has a ceiling fan. Because, Eastern temples have a ceiling.
Yeah.
I think it's really hot in the middle of winter that you need a ceiling. One isn't. Yeah. Fox wheel. The dojo.
I think they did a pretty good job. With optimizing 1 megabyte of RAM.
Yeah, I mean...
1 megabyte of image RAM. Well, actually, no, that wasn't... No, it was 1 megabyte that you could address from... God, no, I've forgotten now. Versus
mode, the temple, I thought you could... The lava pit, the bridge. I know the bridge has one.
I don't think you've given him a...
Dragon. Gee, I wonder who he's based on.
Yeah. I have no idea.
Kim Jong-un?
Yes.
Let's talk about Tour Korea.
No.
Yeah, okay, this is, yeah, this is the one. He throws acid,
what
too.
What was that?
Oh, he's also supposed to have some, like, voodoo powers or something. I think so. I actually think one of his moves is he can, like, shrink you or something like that. Because that's a special move that requires no extra VRAM.
Uh-huh.
Because, you know, no extra frames of animation, because you just scale the sprite down.
Whoa. How'd I do that?
Yeah, it's like, wah, and then, hey.
Yeah.
Oh, damn it. I did it wrong.
Dun, dun, dun.
Also, I don't think I could do the fatality for where you were standing. But hey. And then suddenly he's Urkel, you know. And then hey. He's got his, you know, thousand fists, like E-Honda, whatever.
Just darn it! Right into, I just walked right into that. It was...
Darn it. That was too powerful. How was that too powerful? I just punched you.
I'm sure we get a lot of corrections from the net. We should have done.
Although I'm sure, I bet Kim Jong-un wishes he looked this good. You see College Humor's animated series on Kim Jong-un?
It's sort of like,
it's meant to look like an animated series that was produced in North Korea, you know, complete with crappy style. It's like, Kim Jong-un! Ah.
Jeez.
He's having a seizure. I seriously hope he's wearing some kind of that he didn't actually shave his hair for this game.
Skull cap?
Yeah, or sort of a skull cap, I guess. This, I mean,
hey,
oh, damn it. You know, I'm trying not to kill you. Okay,
I'll just stand here for you.
Well, damn it, there we go.
that's
right,
the graveyard.
That's the graveyard. Okay, okay, yeah.
Worth the wait, was it? Okay.
Yeah, he's got some kind of, like, he'll throw, like, skulls at you or something like that, because he's a... That case just looked like sort of a knife.
If they'd had, yeah.
I think his choice of, hey, is probably, that's probably, like, the one downfall of his character.
No, I think
yeah, hey, it's worth a three-peat. Wow, and his gravity-defying blood that he has there too. It doesn't come back down; it just goes up and. All right, let's try the dojo.
So,
want to try the dojo?
Pardon me.
Let's see if the dojo or whatever.
We could try that, or we could try the other one you brought.
Oh yeah, we brought.
What do you think?
Well, let's just try it. I want to see the fatality in the dojo.
Okay.
I think I know how to do that. The roof. The dojo. Versus... Oh, you're going to do him again?
Yeah, well, I mean, you were clearly able to kick him out of the ring, so...
Okay. The featherweight guy. That guy looks like somebody you'd want to punch, doesn't he?
Well, wearing that expression, yeah. Just to... Woohoo.
Hey. Oh, damn it. Too powerful.
Actually, no, it wasn't a ceiling fan. Wasn't it like a rotating knives? It's like just really explicitly, pointlessly.
You wanna fight? That's his taunt. You want? Oh, no. What's his taunt?
I don't know how to trigger taunts.
It's B and forward, I think. You wanna fight?
Okay.
Fight me! Fight me! That's it. If I remember correctly, that's like his two fights. Alrighty.
Jeez. Oh. Oh, wait, here we go. Pan up. There you go.
Why is that even there? That serves no function. All right. So, now let's put in the legitimate fighting
game, which was
Samurai Shodown.
Okay. Let me get up here. Look out, cat.
We have all the ingredients of a successful internet YouTube series. We've got a cat. We have two hosts playing games for sharp, witty banter. It's
okay.
We just need sponsors. So.
when we get a hit count to within an order of magnitude of Yahtzee's videos, then I think we can think about sponsors.
Yes.
So I remember Way of the Warrior. This I don't remember at all. So
you remember Samurai Showdown?
I remember the Dig Samurai Slowdown, but I don't.
Well, this is a port of a SNK Neo Geo game, which was impressive because this obviously the 3DO at the time this came out cost a lot less than a Neo Geo home system.
Oh wow!
Remember, Neo Geo home systems were $600.
Uh-huh.
We say, that's less than $700. But the games were $200 to $300 because they were cartridges.
Whoa! And they had a huge amount of storage on them.
Yes.
Then. Yeah.
Well, yeah. If you look on the Neo Geo thing, it's like 330 meg.
Wow.
I assume that's megabits, but you know, still for a cartridge, that's large. And so this was a really first-class port of the game. To normal select. Oh, do you have to hit start too?
No. In fact, I have no control at all.
Oh, okay. Let me back out here. Oh. Oh, what the hell. But anyway, so yeah, it did a... And unless you wanted to buy an actual Neo Geo, and this is actually a really spot-on conversion of the, you know, despite having a lot less memory than the hard...
On guard. Cute.
Here, let me see. Can I quit? Because Neo Geo eventually did make the Neo CD, which was a CD-ROM-based version to try and negate the fact that, you know, the cartridges cost that. But then you had, like, a 1X CD-ROM drive.
Oh, dear.
And they didn't do anything to optimize it, so it would literally take, like, a minute to load the games a lot of times.
Wow.
So I can't...
Even the 3DO had a 2X CD-ROM drive.
And, you know, so it was still Neo Geo hardware, and it's not letting me... So I basically... Okay, I pause, but I can't quit, actually. So pause gives me no option to quit or anything.
Okay, and here comes Challenger.
Oh, okay, there we go.
Really? Sorry.
Of course, I didn't want this character, but okay. I didn't want, you know, Toad or whatever, you know... Toad-Wolverine combo that they have here.
Can you move around?
No, I'm stuck in my character.
All right.
Until you defeat me.
I have no idea.
But see, yeah, I mean...
Sure, why not?
And this was... And the funny thing is, I mean, the actual Neo Geo has slowdown in it. And it's not really slowdown, it's more just like they will... Like, during certain moves, they will just... The time in the game slows down. Now, I think some people objected to, like, obviously you don't see this on a real Neo Geo. You don't see, like, the loading screen, because that's a cartridge, so, you know... Mm-hmm. was like, you know, this was, you know, a wet, unlike Street, this was basically, you know, basically SNK and Capcom kind of ruled the day in terms of 2D fighters yes. at the time, and, you know, this was sort of like their, you know, their weapon version of Street Fighter. You know?
No, this does look arcade quality, based on arcade quality at the time.
Yeah, I mean, certainly it was way better than the Genesis and SNES versions of this. Mm-hmm. I mean, this was. And but I think this is the only SNK game they did, and probably SNK probably didn't allow any more after this for the simple reason of, you know, it makes us look bad. You know, they're trying to sell their home system at the same time.
Yeah.
So eventually they did show, you know, they did show up on like the PlayStation,
mm-hmm.
and I'm not sure, maybe the Saturn. And then, you know, of course, Capcom and SNK kind of buried the hatchet, and they started doing Capcom versus SNK games mm-hmm. and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. And
I have a dim awareness of that.
Yeah. Oh, my guy has gone from green, he's now red. That's kind of interesting. I didn't notice it. Yeah. Oh, now he's green again.
Okay. Oh, gosh. Ooh. That's gotta hurt.
And also, I remember Samurai Shodown being like the first one that wasn't seen as sort of like a complete Street Fighter clone.
Hmm.
In terms of like, because they had one that was sort of, I mean, you could literally see it was like, not if something, even the, some of the names were almost like Street Fighter, you know, it was like, you know, yeah. Avenue Warrior or something, you know, something like, not quite that bad, but it was like, you know, World Warriors or something like that. There was a whole bunch of them. It was just sort of like, yeah, SNK is just kind of ripping off Capcom. But then this was one where it's sort of like they came to their own and then, hey, I can enter my initials. Wow, I don't want to.
Wait.
Oh, that's you.
Why do I get to do that? Because
player one.
That's your character. Oh well.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's a glitch. I don't know. Maybe it's so I can insult you. How do you not continue? Oh, I can pick it. Can I pick a new one? No, I cannot.
That's weird.
Well, because I won, so I. That's, I guess, kind of how the arcade is.
It's, okay. So the loser chooses their new.
Pick the guy with the bath beads.
What, this guy?
Yeah. Yeah.
Those aren't bath beads. Whatever. Anyway.
Whatever. Well, are you gonna say something worse than that?
Insert your own joke here.
Yeah. I'm not going there. Yeah. But look, real transparency shadows, you know, as opposed to the...
Oh, the screen door effect.
...thing that Capcom loved to do, you know. Apparently I poisoned you. Briefly there. And, I mean, there was actually...
Oh.
No, I'm just trying to see, like, how they adapted this. Because in the arcade, I believe you have 6 buttons.
Hmm.
Because I know Capcom made a 6-button pad for the 3DO to go with Street Fighter.
Huh.
It's kind of shame that Capcom didn't do more games. They were going to do a Mega Man game. I think they might have actually done a Mega Man game in Japan.
Hmm.
Or at least I remember seeing an advertisement for one. I don't know if they actually did one, which... If they did, I never saw it. Especially when 3DO had all those wonderful Japanese titles out for everybody to pick mm-hmm. through when they were cleaning out their closets.
Yeah. Was like,
God, I wish I'd picked up a copy of that Alfred Hitchcock game, because that sells for a mint on eBay. I remember having that game going, yeah, why would I do this? Judge above. It's in Japanese, I don't understand it, and it's a bunch of clips of Alfred Hitchcock in sliding puzzle games and stuff like that.
Huh. So.
But now it's like, see, now it lets me enter a name. I guess because I'm dead.
Oh, where to put you on the logs? Yeah.
Can I get a space? There we go. Oh, now I can pick somebody.
Now you get to pick
somebody. I can pick Divine. Okay, that's it.
All right.
Well.
All right. Okay.
Doesn't it kind of?
alas, yes.
He was awesome in Hairspray. No, not John Travolta. The original. What the hell? I don't know how I'm doing that.
Is the... Okay, the shoulder buttons don't appear to do anything.
Unless they modify... Maybe that's how they do it. It's like it's a shift to get the other six buttons, rather. There are three buttons. And... The lock of honor embarrasses me. Ha ha ha. Wow.
Okay, I guess if you
Whoa, you sliced me in two there, buddy.
Really? I guess if you mash the arcade C version really quickly.
The arcade version of that is actual blood. Actually, isn't there like an option for blood in this?
I haven't looked.
This is, you know, proto-ESRB days before we were,
Yeah, no, the ESRB was just... Actually, there were two. There was the ESRB and there was another one. And the other one kind of died out, and so all we're left with is the ESRB. But yeah, that was all thanks to... couple of busybody senators who thought that video games were far more important than...
We still haven't done Night Trap, you know.
We have it.
For another day, maybe. Oh, wait. What?
Have you hide? My spear will find you.
How do I...
I didn't do anything.
Oh. Here comes Challenger. Oh, that, okay, so that was just the computer doing that.
All right, hang on.
Okay. They honestly don't have a... Okay. A quit option in here. This is the thing that gets me.
Okay. All right, I'm pushing both start and pause, and nothing's happening.
Maybe just have to let both characters die or something. It's interesting that they have everything loaded up.
Yeah.
They have the level, they have that, they have... It's like, what are they loading up, I guess? Maybe the sound effects? Maybe?
The animations? No, I mean, the rest of the animations? Oh,
okay, maybe it is. I mean, they have enough for them to do a backflip, you know, into the screen.
Ooh.
I am a ninja.
Owie, owie, owie.
I have failed!
Hunzel. Makers of fine swords.
So how was your holiday?
It was okay. It's mostly like family related stuff.
Yeah, you don't have to travel for your family stuff.
No, I don't. I just go, wow, that was quick.
Oh, arterial. Okay, there's the blood.
Arterial spray. There you go. Oh, and you got a perfect, yeah.
Ooh. Perfect arterial spray. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I just says we both live in the San Francisco Bay Area, and I just head north for about an hour. And I did. I got my mom the internet for Christmas.
She didn't have the internet before now?
No, she didn't.
Wow, that's sad.
But yeah, it's like, you know, the cobbler's children. But
she have smartphone at least at the same
time? No. She's this is her first major exposure to tech.
Wow, and I thought my parents were.
She's been lamenting for years now how she wouldn't... This is definitely a let's drown out. She's been lamenting for years now how all her friends and everyone have gone over to email and she hasn't yet. So...
There's a solution to that.
Yeah, and so... But the way I conceptualized it was that I would have to, like, get... cable or DSL installed at her house, and I have to sit and supervise the installation, and then I have to set her up with a machine, and there was no way that machine was going to run Windows because there's no way I'm going to inflict that on my mom. And then my sweetie said, why don't you just get her a tablet hooked up to 4G wireless, you know, 4G mobile? And I thought about what that would cost, and I said, that would actually work really well. So that's what I did. I got her a tablet with 4G, and it's on my account, so she doesn't have to worry about, because she'd always balk when I said, oh, it'd be an extra $30 a month, and she would balk at that.
Oh, dear.
So now she doesn't.
Yes.
So she hasn't done much with it yet, so I'm going to have to figure out...
Wait, is this me?
Oh, no, it's a computer.
Well, die already.
The other guys... Yeah, I'm not doing anything.
I'm not doing... Okay, all of them killed me. I'll let Earthquake... Let's see what Earthquake can do.
Just look but, threatening, it looks like.
Yeah, I mean, I at least got my parents the internet. A couple... Almost... Wow. Almost 2 decades ago.
Oh, wow. Now I, see, now I feel terrible.
Back when it was dial-up modems. Like,
oh, yeah.
And
yeah,
did the transition through that to...
DSL and whatever.
Well, you know, at least my dad, you know, he'd used a PC for work, so...
Mm-hmm.
Although, I think my mom's more proficient at the computer than he is at this day and age. which is... The point of contention. They actually now have two computers, and see, he resides himself to one of the. So basically, I've been upgrading their computers over the years, and so like one will just move to a different room.
Yeah.
And so he's like resigned himself to like the last gen version, and she's like uses more of the current one. Although she just uses it for email and browsing the web.
Right.
Which usually means like Amazon, you know.
Mm-hmm. That's
and the occasional Facebook to check up on my nieces and nephews.
Okay.
She doesn't participate in that. She's more like, and it's like, you're going to be appalled by what you see on Facebook. Even from, you really don't want to know this aspect of your grandchildren's lives. But yeah, I always end up being tech support over the holidays. So it's just like, you know, I usually play IT during the holidays. It's kind of fun.
It's your yearly preventative maintenance.
Oh, God, yeah. Like, my brother doesn't seem to have time to do it for some bizarre reason, even though he lives within a half hour. But yes, it's like, it's one of those things, like, if you buy something for them, it's your responsibility to fix it.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to take on the...
That is another reason why I've waited so long to set my mom up with the internet, because I knew if I set her up with Windows, it was going to fall over dead, because that's just what Windows does. And I would be responsible for going up there every so often and, like, you know, cleaning out whatever garbage had managed to insert itself into the machine.
Well, you know, insert itself. Stuff doesn't just magically install itself nowadays.
Well, there's still drive-by crap malware that's out there through corrupted ad servers and whatnot.
Well, still.
I'll
just make sure she doesn't use Internet Explorer. Just make her use, like...
Yeah, that helps. That helps a lot. Turning off JavaScript also helps a lot. But unfortunately, there's too many sites out there that demand it.
Yeah,
it's like, hi, I want you to turn on JavaScript so I can highlight this link.
At least my parents are pretty good about understanding like the concept of a virus and like how to, you know, because I've explained to them it's like a vampire. You have to invite it in. Don't click on any links. You know, if somebody sends you, hey, you know, and they're pretty savvy about, you know, like. The bank says you a thing, you know, please click on this link because somebody has broken into your bank account or something, you know, that kind of crap because they know about that. So, but yeah, I problem of being the internet age,
no,
the first generation of the internet age, right? Because that means you have to.
Apparently, my mom.
Previous generations, you have to indoctrinate them.
Another scam going around is that someone will call pretending to be from Microsoft.
Oh, yeah! My mom got that.
Really?
Yes! And it was funny, because she, like, immediately figured out.
Yeah.
You know, she's like, she was falling for this for a second.
Uh huh.
And they're like going, no, there's something wrong with your computer. And she's like, no. And she actually played the son card, which is, my son sets all this stuff up. It's like, well, is your son a genius? She's like, yeah, actually he is.
Yeah,
and she actually pulled the, well, where'd you go to school? Like, to the guy on the phone. I was like, well, you know, we know there's something wrong with your computer. She's like, yeah. First of all, she tried the old, oh, I don't have a computer. You know, just kind of pulling, well, we know you have one. She's like.
No, actually, my mom got one of those calls a few months ago, and she verifiably did not have a computer at that time.
And did they say, we know you have one?
We know you have a computer. Yeah, they got kind of belligerent. And just,
oh, yeah, this guy did the same thing. And my mom was just like, My mom
sent them away with a well-chosen expletive.
Whereas I just hang up on these people. My mom actually likes make sport of people who like telemarketers who do stuff on this and like call her up. She thinks this is entertainment to her. It's like,
well, just is there much else to do in Iowa? I mean,
yeah, that's kind of cool. That's why they have a really good home theater system. They have a better one than I do. For that very reason. Well, but yes, it's yeah, telemarketers and people who think that she belongs to the NRA, she will just talk to them for a while just to see like where this is going. It's like, you
know, what are you trying to get at?
Tell me more. Give me your phone number. I want to call you. yes. Well,
I think we've
we'll edit the hell out of this.
Well, I'm sure we will. Well, thank you all for sitting through all this, whatever it turns out to be.
Should we make some New Year's resolutions since it's our first show?
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
Finish Monster Manor.
Definitely. Should I make a resolution to try and get at least one other person who helped participate in that game? Because I've been trying to do that, albeit not with very much effort. I'd like to get... I mean, Kim, unfortunately, is no longer in the area.
Right.
She visits occasionally, but it's... not often enough. There's a couple of other people. I've asked John Loop, and he's demurred. He kind of went, no.
Wait, is he in the area? I thought he
was. Yeah, he is, yeah. He left for a while, now he's back.
Oh. Yeah. I should hook up with him on LinkedIn and see what it
is. See what he's up to.
Yes.
And then, of course, RJ is just busy as all hell.
Yes, RJ. I resolve we do an M2 episode. Because I have an M2, sort of.
Oh.
I have some footage that has been on the net, but not in context.
Oh.
We could do actual M2 titles.
Wow.
I would love to be able to try and get the M2 dev kit working in emulation mode on...
I have an actual Mac in the basement.
I think that's the issue, is the Mac. It's more me remembering the damn MPW command.
Oh, God.
I mean, I finally got an emulation to work to actually, like, it runs stuff.
Uh-huh.
But it's like, God, I can't remember how this is supposed to go in terms of, like, building things.
Yeah, I fired up that Mac, and it came up, like, started off in, like, 640 by 480, which was, like, the default.
Yeah.
And I said, my God, how did we get any work done on this?
You don't. That's why I like the emulator better, because, yeah. A, you don't have to deal with the Mac crashing.
Mm-hmm.
It's an emulator. Well... emulation crash is a big deal. Also, you can run much faster than a real Mac because you're running emulation. So now we have these modern things that aren't measured in megahertz anymore. They're measured in...
Yeah. Yep, gigahertz.
Yes. Awesome.
Yeah.
Remember when a 66 megahertz Mac was the best?
Yeah. 25 megahertz Mac 2. So my 14 megahertz Amiga could run rings around it.
I know.
not as colorful, but yeah.
Yeah, we could.
M2, that could be fun. Trying to get somebody else to help out.
I don't know who else we. Well, who else?
Dale Luck might be up for it. Not, He's a busy guy too.
It's though. Not Luck.
don't start.
yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Oh, that might be interesting. We could give a. We could invite Dale for one of these. I mean, he was around for Opera, obviously.
Yeah, he wrote to the Colonel.
Yeah.
Yeah. He wrote the Colonel for 3 years.
I'm sure he has many a story about Trip that he would love to share.
I think the involved. Day that he got laid off and then unlaid off in the span of about like 6 hours, I think might be an interesting story.
Really? I see that story I haven't heard. That might be an interesting story of like what they suddenly realized, oh my God, he's the only guy that knows about this? Kind of one of those deals?
Something like that.
Yeah.
Well, again, thank you all for joining us, and we'll see which of these we actually follow through in the weeks and months to come.
Yeehaw.
All right. Have fun.
Peace out.